Welcome. My name is Cameron. Today, I'm going to go over the Custom File Explorer sorting plugin, which I did a very comprehensive video on about a year and a half ago. It's a whopping 20-some minutes, and it goes in-depth into all the different ways this particular plugin can help you manipulate your File Explorer, you know, pane in Obsidian. Now, there's been something added since then that I'm going to go over, and I'm going to revisit very quickly the two most common ways that people will probably use this plugin to manipulate their File Explorer and the way that the files and folders in your vault are organized. So, it's by Sebastian MC, a heavy hitter of the Obsidian plugin development community. This is a very, very powerful plugin. A lot of people won't need the functionality that is there, but I think it's really cool to look at everything that it offers so that you have an idea. Yeah, so let's get into this. Once you install it, basically it's going to read information from a sort-spec.md file. There's going to have some stuff basically in YAML in that file, and only that's all that you need. You just need that little YAML. Just sorting-spec, colon, little pipe here, and then whatever your sorting methods are. The very basic one that probably most people will need it for is plain old direct sorting. So you can just list off names of folders and notes in your vault, and it will just automatically organize them. We've got a couple things here. This little guy right here is the custom sorting ribbon button. You can turn it on, you can turn it off. You'll probably leave it on for the most part, but if you change your sort spec file, you're going to want to just toggle it off, toggle it back on so that it refreshes. This is just like a dummy vault. It's got a bunch of like random gobbledygook in there. Then we've got the sort spec file, and we've got the welcome file. Each of these is going to have some stuff inside them too. The sort spec file that we've got in the main root directory of our vault has a bunch of stuff listed here. Then we got a little percentage sign, and then some other stuff. So if we turn it on, it's going to look at the sort spec file in the main vault, and it's going to rearrange this based on that. It's going to look exactly at these names, and it's going to reorder them. The other thing that you can notice here is there's a little percentage sign here. So what does this guy do? Well, let's turn this on, and you're going to see that it's going to change how everything is. So we've got this folder, which matches up here. We've got the sort spec file itself, which matches to there. Then we've got Neptune and Clippings, which are the next two right there. Then we've got a percentage sign in the sort spec, and no percentage sign here, but you can see under the percentage sign is Clipping, and that is the bottom one. So this wildcard here basically means anything that I don't explicitly type into the sort spec file, put it here, organize it here. So that's why it jumps from Clippings to Clipping. I didn't type in any of these names specifically, so it shoves them in there. Now, let's move that little percentage sign right up. We're just going to do a little, and let's just go over here to the welcome one. We're going to turn it off. We're going to turn it on again, and look at that. So now we've got that folder at the very top. Sort spec is the one underneath the percentage sign, so that goes down here, and all the other ones that aren't named are right here. So it's that easy, and as you can see, it treats folders and files the same. Largely speaking, most people are just going to want to organize the main root directory. And this way you can, you know, forego things like adding, you know, 100, 200, 400, or whatever you do to the beginning of directory names or file names so that they get ordered, you know, whatever way you want, but in a more appealing way than, you know, adding numbers or whatever you're doing now. So that's the first super simple thing that you can use this plugin for. If you want to sort something by metadata, you can do that too. I've got a new sort spec file, sortspec.md, in the Saturn folder right here. And so custom sorting is off, so it's just done by the default that's set up in Obsidian, which is just file name A to Z. And if you didn't know, you can actually change the default sorting to a couple different things in Obsidian. File name is the default, but you can change it to modified time or the created time, ascending or descending to your preference. So let's look at this sort spec. This sort spec says A to Z by metadata colon sort. So you can probably guess what this is going to do. So this is going from A to Z by metadata, which is going to be a YAML front matter key. And sort right here is going to be, well, the name of the key value pair in your notes. So you can type whatever you want. There doesn't have to be sort. You can change it to whatever. You know, if you're writing a book or a story or something and you've got metadata that says scene one, scene two, you can have it sort by that number. And so if you end up flipping any of them, it's going to automatically resort them in your vault. So let's turn this on. So now custom sort applied. And something's changed over here, so they're obviously not in alphabetical order anymore. So if we click on this first one, we can expect to see a sort key that's got a value of 1 or 0 maybe, or some low number at least, right? And there we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, etc. Right? If we go to the back one here, it's going to be 8. Very, very simple. Now there's another key here that I put in called sort underscore title. And that has just like a portion of the actual note name. So none of them are going to start with the same letter when I do that. So let's change this to sort title. Just to double check. You can obviously, guess what it's going to do. But let's just double check and make sure. We'll turn that off or turn that on. And yeah, things are a little bit different now. So this sort title starts with A. It's the top one. So you can see that there. This one is actually an L. The new thing that's been added since I did the first video is workaround for drag and drop organization. So if you're not familiar with the bookmarks tab up here, it's one of the like unsung heroes of Obsidian. I really don't think it's utilized nearly enough, but that's probably for another time. So we've got a bookmark folder here called sort spec and one Neptune. And it's got some stuff here. So let's go here and we've got a folder called Neptune. And so the first thing here is this file, which starts with an M. Then we got one that starts with an I and one that starts with an F. So if we look here, M, I, F. Yeah, it looks like those notes match up. Let me turn off the custom sort. Look at that. They go back to alphabetical order. So what's going on there? You can right-click on a file. So when you go into the custom sort menu, you can turn on the custom plugin, of course. But you can also see bookmark it for sorting. So let's click on this guy right here. Starts with an N. Bookmark it for sorting. Now, if we go back to the bookmarks, we can see that that one is now listed right here. Let's turn on the custom sorting, and that new file that we just bookmarked goes up above the one that was there when it was turned on before. Now, this one does not have a sort spec file in it at all. This is just the random notes here. What this is doing basically is it's taking these special bookmark folders and these bookmark notes, and it's applying it to the main file explorer pane. Bookmark it for sorting. So we're gonna put this note right up here at the top. And what we're gonna do is we'll go back here to the file explorer, and it's right down here at the bottom still. And let's just turn that back on. And now it goes up to the top because it's mirroring this bookmark organization setup. It's mirroring this order in your regular file pane. Perhaps a little more user-friendly, or at least if you're going to be reorganizing them a lot, it might be more user-friendly. It just kind of depends on your use case. But regardless of how you do that, this plugin will have something for you. If you've ever wanted to have more control, especially more automated control, over your vault or over your vault, and if you want to apply different rules to different folders, it's super easy. And you can even have one sort spec file in the root of your vault that controls the ordering of all of your directories, if you want to, all of your folders. You can put individual sort spec files into each folder if you want, but you can also separate them out here. And I'm going to link to all the documentation for you to do that. So go check it out, go have fun, and I'll see you next time.